solution. In today's video, we will see the next point. We will take information about the water pollution. Before starting the point, we will discuss the main points related to the water. We use water for different purposes. In that, we use water for domestic purposes. Domestic purposes means what? For bathing, for cleaning, for drinking, for cooking. So, for such domestic purposes, we use water. And with that, we use water for agricultural purposes also and industrial purposes also. And you know that water is useful for the hydropower generation also. It means by using water, we can create electricity also. So, there are such different types of uses are there related to the water. But when we say the water is polluted, that when water becomes unclean and the poisonous due to the mixing natural and the artificial substances in it. So at that time we call as the water is polluted. Again, some things are there that related to the when water becomes harmful to the living organism. When it becomes harmful to the living organism due to the decreased content of O2 level. When whatever O2 means oxygen level or oxygen content level starts to decrease in the water, it becomes harmful to the living organism. And again, one thing is there, when epidemic diseases means what? When at the same time many persons gets affected by the same disease, it is known as the epidemic diseases. And when such epidemic diseases starts to occur, such at that time it is called as a water is polluted. So there are different types of the reasons are there for the pollution of water. So in the next point we will see or we will take the information related to the water pollutants. Now water pollutants means what? The substances which are responsible to cause the pollution of water is called as the water pollutants. There are total 3 water pollutants are present. In that, first one is biological pollutants, second inorganic pollutants, and third one is organic pollutants. So water pollutants are of 3 types mainly, which are that biological, inorganic and the organic pollutants. Now let us see the examples related to each type. Biological pollutants means in that algae, bacteria, viruses and the parasites. These all are the examples of biological pollutants. And because of such biological pollutants, water does not remain potable. Potable means we cannot drink it. And with that, it spreads different types of the diseases also. Okay, so algae, bacteria, viruses and parasites, these all are the biological pollutants which causes the water pollution. Now the second one type of pollutant is inorganic pollutant. In that, fine sand, dust, soil, compounds of arsenic, mercury, lead. So if such type of compounds like arsenic, lead and the mercury gets added into the water becomes polluted. And such, these all examples are there which are coming in which type? Inorganic pollutants. Now the third one type is organic pollutants. For example, weedicides, insecticides, fertilizers, sewage. So such type of examples are coming in which type? Inorganic pollutants. So for as a water pollutants, total how many types are there? 3 types are there, and below of each type I have written example. Observe it carefully. Now let us see the next point related to the reasons of water pollution. In reasons of water water pollution, there are main two reasons are there to cause the water pollution. In that, the first one reason is natural reasons. Some reasons are there which occur naturally, which are responsible to cause the water pollution. And the second one reason, in that man-made reasons are there. Some different types of the activities are there which are done by the human being, and these all activities or these all reasons are responsible to cause the water pollution. Now we will see the first one point, natural reasons. See, in that, in natural reasons, the first one reason is aquatic weeds. Now how aquatic weeds are responsible to cause the water pollution? Because of the aquatic weeds, whatever oxygen content level of water is there, whatever oxygen content present in the water, it starts to decrease. And so it is the one reason to cause the water pollution. And with that, whatever natural quality of water is there, it also get disturbed because of the aquatic weeds. So aquatic weeds, in which reason it is coming? In natural reason, because aquatic weed, it occurs because of the nature, it occurs naturally. Now the second one reason, in natural reason, is decomposing matter. Now decomposing matter, how it is responsible to cause the water pollution? If dead bodies of plants and animals remain as it is for a longer period of time in the water, at that time it starts to decompose. Because of the different types of microorganisms are present, which helps to the decomposition of the dead and decaying organic matter. And if such dead bodies starts to decompose, it gives bad smell to the water, and from that water starts to pollute. So the second one reason, in natural reason, which one is there? Decomposing matter. Now see the third one, mud and the sludge. During the rainy season, when mud and the sludge mixes in the rainwater, and such rainwater when get added into the water bodies, into the river, at that time by mixing such mud and the sludge, water gets polluted. So this is the third one reason to cause the water pollution. Now the fourth one is soil erosion. Now what is the meaning of soil erosion? Soil erosion means wearing away of top layer of soil. During the soil erosion, whatever biotic components and the abiotic components are present in the ecosystem. Biotic means related to the living things, abiotic means related to the non-living things. So such biotic and abiotic components when mixes into the water, it also one reason to cause the water pollution. Now see the fifth one, microbes like fungi and bacteria. Microbes means what? Microorganism. There are different types of microorganisms like fungi and bacteria are present in air. And when in rainy season, or due to the different reasons, when it get mixes into the water, it also one reason to cause the water pollution. See the sixth one reason, algae. That indiscriminate growth of algae, excessive growth of algae, also responsible to cause the water pollution. And the last one point is about the nematodes. Now nematodes means what? The worms, worm-like structure, just like of living organisms, are present in the soil. When it get mixes into the water, worm-like organism means what? Nematode. And just worm-like organisms get mixes into the water, it is also one reason to cause the water pollution. So for the in reasons of water pollution, here we have studied about what? Natural reasons which are responsible to cause the water pollution. Now let us see the second one reason, means man-made reasons. In that, the first one reason is related to the domestic sewage. That when domestic sewage from the villages, from the cities, when directly disposed into the water, it also one reason to cause the water pollution. Second one, industrial effluent. Industrial effluents means what? In that, various pigments are there. Pigments means various types of colors are there, which are used in the industries. Again, with that, bleaching chemicals are there. Again, fibers, mercury, lead. When such material directly disposed into the water, it is also one reason to cause the water pollution. See the third one, oil spillage. That during the transportation or when cleaning of tankers occurs there, at that time some amount of oil or sometimes water, that oil gets directly mixes into the water. So this is one reason to cause the water pollution. Then fourth one reason is related to the use of fertilizers and the pesticides. Mostly fertilizers and pesticides are used by the used in the agricultural purposes for the proper growth of the plants. But when excessive chemical fertilizers are used in the agricultural purposes, such chemical fertilizers and pesticides also one reason to cause the water pollution, because when it get mixes into the soil and when in rainy season such soil get mixes into the water, at that time it directly enter into the water and it affects the ecosystem. And the last one reason is in that other reasons, just type of point I have mentioned here. Other reasons means in that disposal of human waste is there, washing of clothes, washing of animals, again disposal of ashes, and the water from thermal power plant when directly get mixed into the water. These all are the reasons which are responsible to cause the water pollution. So in man-made reasons, total 5 reasons are there, which are that first domestic sewage, industrial effluents, oil spillage, use of fertilizers and pesticides, and other reasons also responsible to cause the water pollution. Now related to water pollution, again one point is there. See that effects of water pollution. How water pollution affects to the human being, to the ecosystem, and some other effects are there which we can see because of the water pollution. First we will see effect on human being. How water pollution affects to the human being, related to that some points I have written. In that, first point is diseases like hepatitis, typhoid starts to occur because of the water pollution. And with that, diseases of skin, liver, kidney, elementary canal. Okay, so diseases related to these organs. Which organs? Related to the skin, liver, kidney and elementary canal also starts to occur because of the water pollution. These are the effects. These all effects we can see in the human being, related to the human being. Now let us discuss about the effects of water pollution related to the ecosystem. Now ecosystem means what? The interrelationship in between the biotic and the abiotic organism is known as the ecosystem. It means in ecosystem living organisms also present and non-living organisms also present. So in ecosystem, water pollution shows effects upon the plant. First point, see here, retarded plant growth. Retarded plant growth means plant shows slow growth, or we can see delay in the growth of the plant. So the first effect of water pollution upon plant, which one is there? Retarded plant growth. The second point is about the loss of plant species. Different types of plant species are there in the environment, which are present on the terrestrial ecosystem and in the aquatic ecosystem also. And because of the water pollution, we can see the loss of plant species also. The third one effect related to the oxygen level. Because of the water pollution, whatever oxygen level oxygen content is present in the water, it gets disturbed. It starts to decrease. So this is the one effect is there, which we can see because of the water pollution. The fourth one effect is related to the disturbance in aquatic ecosystem. In aquatic ecosystem, we can see different types of plants, different types of the animals. But if water of such aquatic ecosystem gets polluted, at that time it directly affects upon the, or it directly disturbs the aquatic ecosystem. And the last point related to the ecosystem is there, death of aquatic animal. And sometimes what we can see, because of the water pollution, we can see death of aquatic animals also. So these are all are the effects which we can see in the ecosystem because of the water pollution. And with these two, again some other effects are there which are causes because of the water pollution, in that changes physical and chemical properties of water. Due to the water pollution, whatever physical and the chemical properties are there, physical property and chemical property means related to the color of water, related to the taste of water. So if when water gets polluted, at that time its taste, its color, we can see change in it. Okay, so changes physical and chemical properties of water, and with that soil fertility also get affected. So these all are the effects which we can see in the effects of water pollution related to the human being, ecosystem. And in other effects we have studied that due to the water pollution, physical and chemical properties of water changes. Now in today's video, what we have learned? We have learned that the types of water pollutants. After that we have studied about the reasons of water pollution. And after that, in last point, we have studied the effect of water pollution. Whatever points I have given on the, I have written on the blackboard, take it in your notebook. Again, few points are there. We will see it in the next video. Thank you.